Getting started with the ActiveReportsJS Viewer. The ActiveReportsJS Report Viewer is a JavaScript control that allows users to load, view, and export reports into PDF, CSV, and HTML formats. The Report Viewer is available in JavaScript, Angular, React, and Vue. We've also added support for Svelte, Next.js, Nuxt.js, and Vite.js. The library is available for download at grapecity.com/activereports/download or via npm using @grapecity/activereports. Before we get started with the viewer, we will need to set up the application that will load the viewer. Open an empty folder inside of your IDE of choice and create a new file and new folder. Name the file index.html and name the folder arjs. Now, inside the ActiveReportsJS folder that was downloaded from the website, copy the dist and styles folders to our new arjs folder. These are the files that we'll use to load the report viewer, as well as any styles. Finally, we need to implement the required JavaScript and CSS files. We're importing several JavaScript files here. The core and viewer files are required to use the viewer. The PDF, tabular data, and HTML files are required to allow users to export reports in their respective file formats. For CSS, we just need two files, the UI CSS file, which includes the core CSS classes, and the viewer CSS file to style the viewer. Now that the HTML file is set up and all of the imports are complete, it is time to implement the viewer. To start, the viewer requires an HTML element that it can attach itself to via ID. For this application, we'll create a div and give it the ID viewer_host. Now inside of the script tag, we'll initialize the viewer. Create a variable and set it to the ActiveReportsViewer control and pass the ID of the div as an argument. Next, the viewer needs a form to open. All we need to do is pass the path to the report. The last step before running the application is to set the size of the viewer. Inside of a style tag, we're going to set the margin, width, and height properties of the div that the viewer is associated with. Now, when we run the application, the viewer will load into the browser. Now that we've got the viewer loaded into the browser, it is time to go over the functionality offered by the viewer. The report that we've loaded includes parameters. If a report includes parameters, the viewer won't load any content until the user makes a selection from the parameter options. After selecting parameters, users can go back and change their selected parameters. At the top of the viewer is the toolbar. This allows the user to change the view of the report, control zoom, navigate pages, and print the report. On the left panel, there are several options to select from. First, we have the search panel, which allows users to search the document for matching values and lets you set match case and whole word properties. If your report has parameters, there will be a button that allows you to view and change your selected parameters in the parameters panel. Finally, we have the export panel. This panel allows users to choose their export file format, set various properties and security on the document, and select the file format version. Then, simply click Export, and the viewer will export your report in the chosen file format. The ActiveReportsJS Report Viewer makes it easy for you to add reporting to your web application and easy for your users to view and export their reports. To learn more about ActiveReportsJS, check out our demos at grapecity.com/ActiveReportsJS/demos.